Hi everyone, and welcome to the What's New and What's Happening in Microsoft Search in Bing session. My name is Lavani Pillay, and I'm a program manager on the Microsoft Search in Bing team. I'm super excited to be here with you today and to share all the awesome work that our team has been up to. And I hope that after seeing all this amazing work that we've been doing, you'll be just as excited about enterprise search as we are. So today on the agenda, we're going to cover what is Microsoft Search in Bing and why it is so important to you and your organization. We'll go into a demo of all the wonderful features and capabilities you can use right after this, and we'll touch upon what's coming soon to Microsoft Search in Bing too. For those of you who may be new to it, let me tell you a little bit more about Microsoft Search in Bing. It is a simple, intelligent search across Microsoft 365 and your company, and it makes finding information in work just as easy as finding information on the web. In fact, a recent study by Forrester Consulting has shown that implementing Microsoft Search in Bing could save companies up to $40 million over 3 years. Now, that might sound like a lot, but just think of all the support tickets that have been saved because your users can now find information in their company, and all the time that has been saved because they can find that information in one place. Believe it or not, IT admins using search effectively can reduce their support tickets by up to 60%. And even save employees up to 82 hours a year otherwise spent trying to find information. Best of all, Microsoft Search in Bing is part of your Microsoft 365 subscription at no additional cost. Sometimes our team refers to Microsoft Search in Bing as MSB, so if you hear me referring to MSB throughout my presentation today, now you know what I'm referring to. So let's jump right into it and see all the wonderful new capabilities that Microsoft Search in Bing has to offer you. So first, I'm going to show you how Microsoft Search in Bing is making it easier than ever for you to find enterprise information no matter where you are in your workflow. For most of us, we're familiar with finding enterprise search information through SharePoint or Office.com or even Bing. But our team has been working really hard to bring Microsoft Search to you no matter where you are. And we've been doing this by deepening our partnerships with the Windows Search Box and Edge so that the experience is seamless. All you need is to be signed in with your Azure Active Directory or work account, and you will get the benefit of finding enterprise search information with just a simple search. Let me show you.
With the Windows Search Box, you now get Microsoft Search in Bing integrated directly into Windows 10. So now, no matter where you are in your workflow, you can find your internal resources through a familiar interface that you already use to find information. Here I can find internal resources like this retail operations site from Contoso and easily get to it. I can also find information about people that I work with, like Lynn, who's our retail planner, and see her contact information, which makes it easy for me to reach out to her. But if I want to learn even more about Lynn, I just hit enter and I go directly to Microsoft Search in Bing, where I can learn so much more about Lynn. I can see her organization and who she reports up to. I can see her recent files that she's been working on and we collaborate on. I see her groups that she belongs to and even her calendar availability, which makes it so easy for me to find a good time that works for us both to meet. With Edge, your work browser, it's just as easy. You now get the benefit of finding both web and work directly from the address bar. You just have to be signed into Edge with your work or Azure Active Directory account, and you can find all this information with a simple search. No longer do you have to remember all these long URLs or try to figure out where to find information. Just search in the address bar. Let me show you. So here I'm trying to find information from Contoso. And as you can see, I have suggestions from both work and web right here. I want to find the news site, so let's take a look. Awesome. I can see my company internal Contoso news site published right here in Bing, and it's so easy for me to get to it with a simple click. Another great thing about Edge is that while I am browsing other sites, I can easily find information from Bing, bringing Microsoft Search in Bing to you. For example, I'm now reading this article on building the workspace of the future. I can see that there is a lot of good information here, but I want to know a little bit more. I see that Diego, a familiar face, has been a contributor to this article, so let me find out a little bit more about him. Now I can do so with Edge's sidebar search. All I have to do is highlight the search term that I'm looking for, right-click, and I click on Search in Sidebar for Diego. Now, right here in my workflow, without having to leave, I can find information from MSB, Microsoft Search in Bing, as well as the web. I can see everything about Diego, from his organization, his files, all the good stuff that we get from Microsoft Search and Bing right here in my workflow. And I even get web information too, so I can have a good overview about Diego. I no longer have to switch context and waste time trying to find information from different places. Another great feature with Edge is Edge's Tap to Search. And soon, Microsoft Search and Bing will be integrated into Edge's Tap to Search so you can find work information directly from the address bar. Here, you can use keyword searches like work, and if you hit tab, you're now searching for work information directly. You can also use keywords like your company name or even customize it to be something you prefer. Now, as I'm searching in the search box, like for Contoso, I'll see suggestions for my company that are only work results. Previously, I showed you work and web in the address bar together, but now I just have work results. And when I hit enter, this is the best part. Now I go to Microsoft Search in Bing's work vertical. This is a brand new user experience that we launched earlier this year. And it's really awesome because it's a dedicated and focused workspace right here in Bing for you to find all your enterprise search content. It brings a whole new level of productivity to Microsoft Search Ola. Here I can find everything from people, groups, sites, files, conversations, and a whole bunch of new content I'm going to get to in just a second. But we always continue to serve the best of both web and work in one space, right here in all. And no matter how you land in Bing, whether it's from Edge, the address bar, or the Windows search box, we will always give you the best of work right here in Bing. You can now easily get to the work vertical by just clicking on the work tab or clicking on the see all results from Contoso, and you get that dedicated workspace I was talking about. My favorite feature about the work vertical is the search box. Let me show you why. Here I get all the suggestions only for work. I can see files, sites, and even groups. And I can easily get back to the web by just clicking on this link, search the web for marketing. With this, you really get the best of both worlds with Bing, where you can get all the best of web and work in one space. As I've mentioned, the work vertical has really allowed us to expand our reach and bring in a whole bunch of new content to Microsoft Search and Bing, so that you don't have to think about where to find all this content. It's just in one space. And with that, first-party data connections are a huge priority for us. So I'm really happy to share today that across Microsoft Search and Bing, Office and SharePoint, you can now find all your Power BI reports and dashboards with just a simple query. For example, let's find some reports about sales. With just a simple query, I can see all the reports and dashboards that are relevant to me right here in Bing for Power BI. And I can see more of those, which takes me to this dedicated tab by just clicking on this link or the tab itself. Now I can see even more reports that are relevant to me for sales. And we will continue to bring even more first-party data connections to Microsoft Search and Bing soon, like Dynamics 365 and Azure Cognitive Search, so that you really can find all your Microsoft data right here in Microsoft Search. Now, while first-party data connections are super exciting, I'm sure many of you are thinking about your third-party data connections. Information like your on-prem websites or your media wiki, stuff like your support tickets that may be in ServiceNow, or even your Salesforce information. Well, today across Microsoft Search, we're super excited to share that we now support third-party data connections too. And across Microsoft Search in Bing, Office, and SharePoint, you can now find all this information with a simple search. I will share a session for admins who are interested on the graph connectors in Microsoft Search so that you can learn a little bit more about how to configure these and manage them so that it's best for your organization. So be sure to catch that at the end of this session. But right now, let's take a look at how all this works right here in Microsoft Search in Bing. Now, with just a simple query like marketing campaign, I can find information across my company, no matter whether it's from the Microsoft Graph or whether it's from a third-party data source. It doesn't matter. Here, I'm able to get a good overview of all this information that's most relevant to me. You can see that we're surfacing Salesforce data too in this view so that you get a better overview of the most relevant information. This is something we call a result cluster. And now in public preview, as an admin, you'll be able to configure this so that it works best for your organization. If we click on this link to see more Salesforce data, you can see even more about this account or opportunity, where you can learn about who owns it the stage that it's in, or even the date that it's closed. But you can also see all the accounts for our company captured in Salesforce. And with a simple query like account, I'm able to get a good overview of all the accounts. I'm able to see the contact information, and all of this, as I mentioned, is customizable by the admin. But not just Salesforce data. Now, if I search for something like travel, I'm able to see information, whether it's SharePoint or on-prem sites for travel in my company. Again, by clicking on this link, you can now go to the on-prem vertical where you can see more websites that are relevant for travel. This really makes searching for information across my company really easy in Microsoft Search and Bing.
So I'm sure as an admin, while all this content is really exciting, you're wondering, well, how do I configure and customize all of this so it's the best for my organization? Well, now across Microsoft Search and Bing, Office and SharePoint, you can customize all your first-party and third-party content so that it works well for you. You can rename, disable, or even create custom verticals with custom query templates so that the information is best for your users. Make sure to catch the Microsoft Search Customization and Extensibility session to learn out more about how to do this in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center.
So you've heard me mention Microsoft Search and Bing, Office and SharePoint together quite a few times today in my presentation. And that's because everything that I've shown you today is available across Microsoft Search and Bing, Office and SharePoint. All that information that I showed you when I searched for marketing is available right here in office.com. The internal sites and the third-party data connections. Look, I can find MediaWiki and even Salesforce information, those on-prem websites and so much more. I can also find information in my organization like people. And now you can see the exact same information that I showed you on Bing right here in office.com too. We really do work together to bring you the best enterprise search experience no matter where you are in the Microsoft ecosystem and continue to deliver on our promise in Microsoft Search.
And don't forget that Microsoft Search and Bing is with you wherever you go on mobile. Now, you just have to sign into bing.com on your browser on your mobile device and sign in with your Azure Active Directory or work credentials. You can now start searching for all the wonderful work content that I showed you earlier. I love this because in the current situation today, while working from home, I'm able to find more information about people, check their availability, and even other internal resources while I'm multitasking and on conference calls or trying to do something else. This makes it easy for me to have MSB with me no matter where I go. So I've already showed you a whole bunch of cool new stuff that's in Microsoft Search and Bing today, and I'm sure that you're super excited to go try that out. But there is good news. There is more coming soon to Microsoft Search and Bing. We continue to bring you even more first-party data across Microsoft. So Dynamics 365 is one of the first next ones we will start bringing in. Here you can find all your CRM needs from your accounts, your leads, your contacts, everything that you have in Dynamics 365 now available through Microsoft Search and Bing. We also will bring through Azure Cognitive Search so that you really have one place to find all your first-party information. We also continue to bring you even more in the Microsoft Search and Bing work vertical. We continue to hear your feedback and to make sure that we bring you an amazing experience that is relevant and efficient. So first, we will bring in refiners that are both out of box and custom to help users find information even more easily and narrow down their search. We will also bring in a feature called Who Knows What. And while we know that searching for people today is really great, we also know that it's super hard to find people by their subjects or topics that they may be experts in. Well, Who Knows What allows you to do that by helping you find people across your organization that are experts in a matter so that you can connect with them. So some of you may be thinking, I want all this goodness that you showed me today, but I'm still an on-prem customer or just not fully migrated to the Office cloud. Well, the good news is we have something available for you too, Microsoft Search Standalone, which is giving you a modern organization-wide search experience no matter where you are at in your cloud journey. You really can have everything we've shown you in Microsoft Search and Bing today with this. You can learn more about a Microsoft Search Standalone by going to AKAMS, WAC MSFT Search Standalone, and you can learn more about this there or sign up for the private preview. So as I mentioned earlier about the graph connectors in Microsoft Search, as well as the customization and extensibility session, here are the details on how to catch those so you can learn more about how to configure and customize the content you will be bringing into Microsoft Search and Bing. I hope everything that I've showed you today has you more excited than ever about Enterprise Search and Microsoft Search and Bing and the positive impact that it can have on you and your users to help find internal resources in your company. So get out there and start using it to make you even more productive. Thank you so much for watching.